From lingual glands, we receive an enzyme named lingual lipase. The term lipase tells us that this enzyme is capable of breaking down lipid. The most plentiful lipid in our diet is triglyceride, which is a molecule made of a backbone named glycerol and three fatty acids. However, we have other type of lipids in our diet. For example, phospholipid is also another lipid that lipase enzymes can actually break down. One well-known phospholipid that we have in our diet is lecithin. And lecithin is a molecule that is used to, for example, synthesize some neurotransmitters such as acetylcholine. As you know, acetylcholine has many important activities in our body. For example, that's the neurotransmitter that is released from somatic motor nerves to stimulate our skeletal muscles. So in short, we can say that our voluntary body movement depends on the release of acetylcholine. And also the recommendation for Americans is that 20 to 35% of our daily calorie intake should be from lipid. So that's important to note that we must have lipid, obviously within balance in our diet. And the enzymes that break down lipid are lipase enzymes, and we have only three lipase enzymes. As I mentioned, the first lipase enzyme is released from lingual glands in tongue, and most resources clarify that lingual lipase does not release in an active form. Basically, when we swallow food and eventually the lingual lipase gets inside the stomach, it interacts with hydrochloric acid, which would be one of the secretion of parietal cells. Parietal cells are some of the cells that line the stomach. And as a result of this interaction, lingual lipase becomes active. So in short, we say hydrochloric acid inside the lumen of stomach activates lingual lipase. And lingual lipase is in charge of chemical digestion of about 30% of the triglyceride molecules that we have in our diet. However, lingual lipase is not the only lipase that works inside the stomach. In the lining of the stomach, as we know, we have non-ciliated simple columnar epithelium, and one of those columnar cells would be referred to as chief cells. And chief cells release different secretions, including an enzyme named gastric lipase. So from chief cells that we have in the lining of stomach, we also receive gastric lipase that can break down the lipid molecules. However, it is interesting that even though cells in the lining of stomach release gastric lipase, but this is the enzyme that works the best in an environment that is pH is around 5 to 6. And inside the stomach, the gastric juice is more acidic than that. The pH of gastric juice is usually between 1.2 to 3. So we see that due to the acidity that we have inside the stomach, gastric lipase has limited role in breaking down lipids. So two enzymes break down lipids inside the stomach. One is lingual lipase, the other one is gastric lipase. When we make a comparison between the activity of these two enzymes, we realize that lingual lipase actually is more active. Then from stomach, we know chyme is going to move through the process of gastric emptying, goes through the pyloric sphincter and gets inside the small intestine. And when I focus on duodenum, the beginning of small intestine, I notice that we receive bile through the bile ducts. So that would be, for example, common bile duct. And also we receive pancreatic juice through pancreatic ducts. So bile and pancreatic juice both are released into the duodenum of small intestine. In bile, we do have bile salts, and bile salts are amphipathic. Amphipathic molecule simply means that one region of a bile salt is hydrophilic, polar. The other region of bile salt is hydrophobic, it's nonpolar. So what the bile salts do, they interact with large lipid globules that get inside the lumen of small intestine. And from their hydrophobic region, they interact with these large lipid globules. And from their hydrophilic end, they interact with the watery chyme that we have inside small intestine. And the result would be breaking down the large lipid globules into smaller lipid globules. And when bile salts break down large lipid globules into smaller ones, we call this process emulsification. So we say that the first thing that we need when we are inside the lumen of small intestine is emulsification, breaking down the large lipid globules into smaller ones. And these small ones are ready for the last lipase that we get from pancreas, and that would be referred to as pancreatic lipase. So now pancreatic lipase in the lumen of small intestine can break down triglyceride, and actually between the three lipases that I mentioned, lingual lipase, gastric lipase, and pancreatic lipase, most digestion of triglyceride happens by pancreatic lipase. Pancreatic lipase separates two fatty acids from the triglyceride molecule. So we end up with glycerol and one fatty acid still attached together. That would be a monoglyceride and fatty acids. So we say that when pancreatic lipase breaks down triglyceride into monoglycerides and fatty acids, we complete the digestion of lipids. What we have, we must absorb them. However, when we focus on, for example, the fatty acids, we see that some of the fatty acids that we get in the lumen of small intestine are short-chain, lightweight fatty acid molecules. If that's the case, through the wall of small intestine, we can absorb those short-chain fatty acids directly into the fenestrated capillaries that we have in submucosa of the villi of the small intestine. But when it comes to absorption of large lipid molecules, such as monoglycerides or long, heavy chains of fatty acids, the process of absorption is different. And we see that eventually inside the absorptive cells that line small intestine, we must form a large compound that is called chylomicron and absorb chylomicron into lacteal. When we say lacteal, we refer to the lymphatic capillary that we have in submucosa of the villi of the small intestine. The difference is that lacteal, the lymphatic capillary, is more permeable than the blood capillary. So a large compound such as chylomicron cannot get into the blood capillary, but it can easily get inside the lacteal. And we know that lymph eventually will be drained into our bloodstream, into the venous system. So the only difference is that when we learn about the absorption of lipid molecules, if they are short chain and small, we can absorb them through the wall of small intestine directly into blood. But if they are large and heavy, we must absorb them into the lymph and then allow lymphatic system to eventually take them into the bloodstream. And the last thing that I would like to emphasize is that for lipids, we do not have brush border enzyme. We just have three lipases: lingual lipase, gastric lipase, and pancreatic lipase. And as I mentioned, pancreatic lipase is the one that does the most digestion of lipids.